Hey crypto fam, I'm Chris with Exodus, and in this video, we're going to look at a coin that needs no introductions. Even if you're someone relatively unfamiliar with the crypto ecosystem, you've probably heard of Ethereum, the de facto number two, and indeed probably the most famous cryptocurrency after Bitcoin. Ethereum forever changed the use cases of the blockchain. From an open ledger to facilitate only peer-to-peer transfers of money, the blockchain became a platform upon which smart contracts and decentralized applications, the famous dapps, could be built. After all, the much-expected Ethereum 2.0 is scheduled to launch this year, but more on that later in our Ethereum analysis, where we answer the question, what is Ethereum? A global, open-source platform for decentralized applications. That's the one-line description on Ethereum.org, with thousands of games, decentralized exchanges, and finance apps running on top of the Ethereum blockchain, not to mention tokens. It's right on point. This extended functionality for the blockchain was envisioned in 2013 by Vitalik Buterin. In the months that followed, Vitalik joined forces with several other people in order to launch the new blockchain. But usually only he, and to a lesser degree Gavin Wood, are referenced as the co-founders of Ethereum and the Ethereum Foundation. I guess I just did it too. The Ethereum Mainnet was launched in July 2015 and was very quickly widely adopted, which led Ethereum to climb to number two in just a few months from the launch. And with the exception of very brief periods, it has kept that place ever since. Ethereum, of course, is not the only smart contract blockchain out there. Several competitors have emerged during the years, like EOS, Tron, Algorand, Cardano, and many, many others, which look to build on the successful model of Ethereum while overcoming some of the limitations. Ethereum, however, is still the most popular smart contract on the blockchain, with almost half of the top 100 coins running on the Ethereum network. But Ethereum does have shortcomings, with the most significant being its limited scalability. This became abundantly clear during December 2017, but it wasn't the increased transactions due to the bull run that brought the network to its knees. It was a game, the infamous CryptoKitties, where the users spawn, collect, and exchange digital kittens. It was the first dApp that tested and broke the network's limits. During that time, transaction fees skyrocketed, and many transactions never even made their way onto the blockchain. The reason for this congestion is because every action in the game and in every dApp is a transaction on the blockchain, with thousands of kitties being born, sold, and bought every second, and the network being able to facilitate only 15 transactions per second, the herd of kitties overwhelmed it. CryptoKitties' popularity has declined since then, but today another industry has emerged to saturate the network, Ethereum DeFi, or Decentralized Finance. This is a collection of dApps, with Compound Finance and Uniswap being the most popular amongst them, that offer traditional banking products on the blockchain, without the need for banks. Users can lend their ETH and other Ethereum ERC20 tokens, usually stablecoins like DAI and USDC, and others can borrow them by providing collateral with their own crypto. The borrower pays interest, which goes to the lenders as the reward. And of course, everything happens automatically and on-chain with the use of smart contracts. In that way, one can get access to money without having to liquidate their own funds, and most importantly, without having to go through a bank. This is DeFi's most significant promise, to bring banking services to the millions of the unbanked. Although DeFi gets the lion's share for the congestion on the network, it's Ethereum's overall popularity that led to it. Most Tether tokens are now ERC20 tokens. Decentralized exchanges like the Kyber network and Uniswap run exclusively on Ethereum. Even whole virtual worlds like Decentraland live on the blockchain. And again, not to mention the thousands of tokens that run on top of it. The applications of smart contracts are endless, and Ethereum is the spear's head. It's only now natural that the limits would be reached, especially if we consider that it was designed more than 5 years ago, when even the word cryptocurrency was unknown to most. Enter Ethereum 2.0. The much-expected upgrade to Ethereum will change significantly the way Ethereum works, and promises to solve the scalability issue, making Ethereum capable of supporting the tremendous workload from all these smart contracts. The most significant change that Ethereum 2.0 will bring is that it will transition Ethereum from a proof-of-work consensus mechanism to a proof-of-stake mechanism. Right now, blocks are validated and added to the chain by miners who run expensive mining equipment and consume a lot of energy in an attempt to be the first to solve a mathematical problem and add a block to the chain. This high cost is necessary to keep miners honest and secure the network. With proof-of-stake, the energy cost is replaced by a financial commitment. Ethereum 2.0 staking involves committing 32 ETH to the network. By staking that amount, you become a validator, which gives you the opportunity to add new blocks to the chain. This can be done even with a laptop, and of course, you get rewarded for your efforts in securing the network. The other significant change that Ethereum 2.0 will bring is the introduction of shard chains. These are individual blockchains that run in parallel with the main chain, called the beacon chain. Each shard chain's purpose is to take on part of the load of validating and adding new blocks to the chain, while the beacon chain makes sure all the shard chains are up to date with the latest data. This way, the network is able to process an increased number of transactions per second. Additionally, the nodes in each shard will need to download and process only the transaction history of that shard, not the whole network. These two characteristics combined will increase the capacity of Ethereum and aim to solve the scalability problem. Ethereum will become a superhighway of interconnected blockchains, as the foundation calls it on Ethereum.org. The new version of the network will launch in three phases. Phase 0, which will see the introduction of the beacon chain, is expected to become live by the end of 2020. The latest Ethereum 2.0 news on the matter is that the final testnet of the beacon chain, named Medalla, was launched on August 4th, and when all the hiccups are overcome and all the bugs squashed, the mainnet beacon chain will be launched. So, no exact date yet. At first, the beacon chain will be of limited capabilities because there won't be any shard chains to keep in sync, only itself. Its main purpose during this phase will be to register validators and coordinate everyone's staked ETH. Then comes phase 1, which is expected to launch in two steps within 2021. The first step is the debut of shard chains, which will start to validate transactions, but won't support accounts or smart contracts just yet. The Ethereum Foundation plans to launch phase 1 with at least 64 shards. The second step is named phase 1.5, which I guess this is the result of realizing you actually need a fourth phase, but don't want to renumber the whole thing. In the second step of phase 1, the current mainnet of Ethereum will become a shard itself, and it's at that time that the full transition to proof of stake will happen. Finally, phase 2, the final phase, which will include the full capabilities of the shard chains, where they'll be able to process smart contracts, communicate with each other more freely, and developers could even design shards in their own ways. The concluding Ethereum 2.0 release date, that of phase 2, is the most uncertain at the moment, and it's placed at some point after 2021. As is reported on Ethereum's official site, the phase is currently, quote, very much in the research phase. With Ethereum 2.0 explained, what's your take on it? It's been talked about and expected for years. Now that it's right around the corner, do you think it'll bring the promised scalability and silence the voices of Ethereum's critics? Let us know in the comments below, and if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to click that like button and subscribe to our channel for more crypto videos from Exodus. That's all for now. Until next time, hold on.